Hi, I'm Chuck Taylor. I'm the program manager for Autonomous In-Space Assembly here at Langley, where we're building the next generation of robots for in-space assembly. And they're being tested on the flat floor here because this represents zero G. In the past, we've launched every part of a mission within a single rocket. And we're getting to the point where the missions we want to execute in space are much larger than the rockets we have to put them on orbit. And so you end up having to do some kind of assembly on orbit. In 2000, the International Space Station was basically built that way using astronauts as the assembly tool. We want to get to a point where we're using robots. We want to do that because it's a lot cheaper to have robots doing the assembly than humans, where you have to bring along all the safety logistics that's required whenever you put a human on orbit. So if we can package all the materials we need within a single rocket and then assemble it once we're on orbit, we believe it's a much cheaper way to go about the next generation of space exploration than trying to do what we did 20 years ago. What you're seeing behind me is the Talisman arm. It's a long-reach manipulator. It basically is the rough equivalent of the crane. Its function is to move things around or to bring tools to a worksite. And then we have smaller tools like the Ninjar or the Samurai robots, which basically are the manipulators. The Samurai's basic function is to get small struts and hand them to the Ninjar so that you're building things piece by piece to make a firm structure. This project is all about developing a toolkit for in-space assembly. So we want our tools to be applicable to a whole host of missions that NASA or the federal government might have an envision for space.